An update has happened. Particularly, you look at the rewards box. Look at those colorful pictures. Those were new. I think those were new. I think they were all the same color before, and it was kind of hard to tell what you're looking at here. But more substantial. Now when you press the square button at the bank, you get exactly what I hoped you would get. Which is you get sorting. Look at this. It goes yoga shroom, then transparungus, then grilled mushroom, then grilled life shroom. Look how they're all together. Then bronze skill shroom, and so on, and so on. You know, sorting. Like how things are supposed to work. And this is so much more useful. I would still love to have my resources listed as you, like just a vertical list that's the name of the resource with a little icon next to it, and then next to it like a times 7 or something saying how many you have. Because this is still like, you have to count how many you have, which is still awkward for when you're talking about an inventory that has literally hundreds of slots. But this is progress. Now what they need to do is they need to add better images for these things. Because some of these are like the same. Let's see. I guess these are different technically. You have to look really closely, but technically that's not the same color as that. But it's really hard to see. But yeah, now when I have a full inventory and I'm like, I have good resources that I want to store. What do I do? I can look in my inventory here and be like, oh, look, is that like 2 rows of hemp? That's probably too much hemp. I guess I could throw away some hemp and that kind of thing. So now I know how much of each thing I have, which means that I can actually make decisions about my inventory because it's all sorted in a way that makes sense. And this is important progress and it makes me happy. And all you do is hit the square button and it just happens. So now on top of having these filters, we also have them in an order that makes sense. So now I can tell exactly what's going on, and this is great news. Now I just want to see alternate display options. And for the record, I am clicking right stick right now for a switch display, but I'm pretty sure that changes the tooltip on the bottom of the screen, not the display sequence. Because I would love to see a vertical, list that's just names, basically, and how many of each thing you have. Like the stores in Tales of Berseria or something like that. Either way, it's something to work with. Also, when I checked in today, I had been attacked. It's okay, I only lost like 1,000 gold from 2 attacks. Defenses still consistently fail. But it said my team won, and I got money. I got 4,500 of each for winning. It said Yotsuyama fought against Yotsuyama, and 0 matches happened. And Yotsuyama lost, and Yotsuyama won. And I'm like, I'm not Yotsuyama, why are you showing this to me? And then it gave me money. And I'm like, what? Why am I making money? Also, no matches happened. I think it was a glitch. Oh well. I got money. Alright, so I'm on my way to Mokumagome, which is floor 6, I believe. Because at this point, I'm back in the territory of basically whenever I see a neighboring zone I've never been to before and it's connected and I haven't explored it yet, I'm just going to go for it. Because that's just something that's an enjoyable way to play the game in general. And right now, my big push for progression has been somewhat rebuffed. When bad things happened. Am I about to get attacked on both sides? The answer is yes. Hi there. No. What? Stop that. Huh. Did not expect that to hit me. So I guess I wasn't being attacked on both sides, but now I am. Well, attacked, that is. Uh-oh. That was poorly done. There we go. Oh yeah, you give me that unarmed experience while I turned down the audio because I forgot that I am not playing Mass Effect. I am playing Nightmare Loud Game Man. Okay, so right over here, if I go up purple, that leads somewhere. I don't know. Maybe it'll connect to that down teal over there. Because if not, that's where I'm gonna go next. If this is a dead end store thing, I like exploring the tower. And even if it gives me 4 variations, so I have to kind of re-explore elements of it to keep refilling it in. And it may give us a chance to fill in our resources as we go. That for stuff that might be necessary for various upgrades, although I'm not necessarily confident that'll happen on floor 6 for the current upgrades. But generally, I like to find where everything's going to take me. And it gives me a chance to get more unarmed experience by punching these guys out. Oh, wow. Good intercept. So I basically just came in here without buying any new gear. I'm just wearing what I was already wearing. So that'll likely will break, but that's fine. I'm not really... I shouldn't be in much danger unless I encounter haters, because those could be high level. Fireworks, no! Goodbye. Goodbye. I'm gonna hit max level if it's the last thing I do. Well, on unarmed. Obviously, my actual character's already at the maximum level, in case we were somehow missing that detail. Where's purple up? That looks like it's gonna be a down. It's a down, it's a purple down. Back to Hyakudori. Which for some reason is the one specific floor name that sticks out the most in my brain, and I don't really entirely know why. Another reason to check out these side floors as they show up is because they could be locations of stamps, and of course I want every stamp for reasons that are not entirely clear. Aw, jungle machete. That was a game changer when I found the recipe the first time, but now every time it shows up it's just going to be a disappointment. Here we go. We're definitely firmly in the territory because of... Ooh, whoa. Because of slightly gated progression, I'm basically in the territory of doing whatever the fuck I want. Whenever, as to pass the time. Oh, let's check out that little chunk of map that's not explored yet. Oh, let's see if I can fill up a collector inventory with random bullshit. And maybe it'll help me craft something. And that kind of stuff. Friend. Oh god. Mistakes were made. Terrible mistakes were made. How was that a perfect guard? I was just holding it down. Weird. Oh well. I'll take it.
That's epic, bro.
That was a completely accidental perfect guard. I just happened to be holding guard, and I guess my character must have finally raised his arms just in time for a deflection. Neat. Same one again. What do we got to do over here? Aye, friend. Oh, that's not how you roll around somebody. That's how you roll directly into somebody like a stupid head. Oh no, my new traffic cone head is gone. But it was my favorite. I gotta get all these rolls down between Dark Souls and Neo and Let It Die. I've gotta get it straight in my head what's gonna happen when I try to hit certain directions plus roll when I'm fighting enemies. Ow. Ow. That wasn't very nice. Hey, what? How are you still comboing me? You can stunlock somebody off a cliff and then keep stunlocking them and keep attacking them? Oh, you silly video game. You were silly. Unfortunately, they knocked me off and I didn't see what the, oop. Fluffy fungus. I definitely don't need that anymore. I'm pretty sure I finished that quest a while ago. They knocked me off the cliff though, so I didn't see what the item was. It was probably money, because it looks like it's gone. Ooh, hi. Worth it. One of the nice things about this game's design is the fact that if you're just screwing around, you can just keep finding things to do that start technically making progress. So I'm finding side paths that might lead to stamps or might lead to me finding new locations for farming resources or for special stores or even special gauntlets that give me blueprints or anything like that as a reward, perhaps. But on top of that, I get to do this, which levels up my unarmed, which is good because... I need to have maxed out unarmed so I can do the most possible damage in situations. Ah, crap. Sasori. Ow, shit. Nope, no more of that. I'm done with you. There we go. I need to be able to do the maximum possible damage. Let's put you over here. Oops. I need to be able to do maximum possible damage in situations where my my stuff breaks. Because obviously there's a very real risk of your armor wearing out in this game. Your armor and your attacks and basically everything can just fail on you. So I gotta be prepped or I'm gonna be dead, as I have been before. Because being in a dangerous situation with no weapons is rough. So I need every advantage I can get from just my normal character's raw stats. And if anything, because of how rough some of the stuff has been, I definitely want to have unarmed just ready for when it's time to go deeper into the tower. Aha! I can surprise you when I get you to go around corners. Now I just need some pants. The fact that I just knocked out a trucker and took his hat, like, I'm just thinking of Terminator now. Give me your clothes. With the gap in dangerousness between me and the people around here, that's not where the platform was. It's not an unfitting comparison. Up we go. Yep.
Boom.
Come on, iron. Oh. I just want the iron blueprint. Oh, crap. That's not what I wanted. Oh, well. I guess I'll eat this one random heart shroom I've got in my inventory for some reason. Mistakes were made. Really? Really? Just gonna fight me on this, huh, game? Basic platforming? There we go. See, those kind of moments make me real nervous about doing boss fights that have platforming in them, because what if I just die horribly midway through that? Alright. Let's not be as stupid this time. Here we go. Okay, you guys know where purple up is? Please? Please? Yeah, I quite liked using iron for a while, but the fact that I can't craft my own irons means they don't get any stronger, and the ones that other people drop are crap. It's nice, because it's got like a weird delayed AoE thing going on. This guy knows what's up. Don't know if irons are long-term viable or not. I imagine a lot of the weapons are probably viable in the long-term if you can find the right upgrade materials. Hi. Surprise. You surprised me is what happened. Oh, you're level 8. That's adorable. You're adorable. My clothes. I need those to be clothed. It's pretty much their one job, really. Hey, you. There we go. I like the part where I punched you until you stopped moving. That was a good part. There's nothing down here? Oh. Oh. Nah, I am just wearing a trucker hat. And that's it. We're having a day is what we're having. Let's not drop down there. Take it slowly. Trying to murder myself with falls. Hello, Boom Shroom. Do I still need you guys for progress? Nope. Alright, I can just throw it at somebody. There's that. Mocha Magome. Is this the Jin-Die boss fight again? It is! Oh. It's another optional path that comes out of this boss fight, apparently. So, like, that's just a thing that happens a lot here, apparently. She looks happy. Healthy. I'm sure she's eating healthy.
She'll never see me coming. She totally saw me coming. Didn't work.
Yep. Aha! Oh. Good. Come on, you spawned. You teleported here. What? That's not the direction I pressed. Freaking game teleporting me in the wrong direction. Oh. Well, boss fight over. There we go. That's weird thinking that she's only on floor 6. Just because I'm thinking of how long it took for me to get to the point where I was dealing with her. I really did make the first floors last, didn't I? Alright. So somewhere in this chamber, probably, is a new door I haven't done yet. Are you purple up? Yes, you are. Yes, you are. You're, Ragashikoya. I'm on to you, Ragashikoya. And I'm not wearing clothes. Come at me, Ragashikoya. I've got butt cheek red lines. These are weird clothes. I forgot what... Oh, it goes places! And it totally does connect to that location like I thought. So my priority should be teal down, because that goes somewhere different, as opposed to just connecting to the other floor. We're finding places! Hey, that person seems perturbed. Suck this down, no. Bad. Oh, he blocked it. What will I do? What will I do? Ah, I didn't see it in time. I had already queued up the next attack. It's funny, because if you look at the quick time event, it's so obvious that you're like, obviously you should just do the thing. Like, just hold the triangle and do the thing. Do the execution kill. But it's actually surprisingly hard to respond to it, because if you pressed a button already, like, seconds ago, then it's still queued up and it's still going to hit them, whether you see the quick time event or not. Can you come down here, please? Hi there. Ow.
I liked that hat, you dick.
I was actually rather indifferent to that hat, if we're gonna be completely honest. There's resources on this floor. Look at that. Gonna grab you. I should probably grab the stuff down there, too. Hey, buddy. Oh, where are you going? Oh, he's going the long way around. Where are you going? Oh, hi.
Yee-hee!
Hope you weren't using that spine. It's pretty amazing how you just straight up split them in half when you do that kind of attack. Like, it doesn't even come close to making sense, and I love it. Oh, missed my step. That was halfway down. Bing. Clinty Magnum. Why do you disappoint me so, game? Why do you do this to me? I only give you my... I give you all of my stuff. Everything you would ever want. And you betray me. Bing. Might as well. Just have it prepped for later. So this is a gauntlet. Says holding. Oh, it only closed behind me, not in front of me. Is he gonna come attack me? There's animals in here. I'm just waiting for the other shoe to drop now. Ooh, clothing. I do like to steal clothing. Well, how did you know? Are you aggroed yet? Where are you? There he is. Hi there. It's nice to meet you. Goodbye. Aww. You will live on in my memory as a hat. Am I under attack? How locked? Oh! Neither of these things have twisty things on them. There's no valves. You can't open them. You have to find some other way to open them. Interestingly. And you get cooked, and you get... How did you miss? Oh, you didn't miss, kind of. Yes, I am using the crappy one I found. And you get a cook. And you get cooked. Is this how hunting works? You shoot people with pre-cooking devices and they're magically edible immediately? It seems so humane. It is killed instantly. You place the shears at the base of the crab's skull and then you cut its head off. This kills the crab. Here we go. Well, now I've got a bunch of those. Why not? Thank you. Thank you very much. I feel like something bad's gonna happen the way that it's shepherding me in this direction. Am I trapped? What? What the higgity heck? It's like a... Did I miss something, or is this a new thing? Because it seems like a new thing. So, there's no valve to let me escape. So it's a mandatory floor change. That's actually kind of terrifying. Because what if the mandatory path was pushing you somewhere dangerous? Like, what would you even do about that? Oh, that's scary. Oh, that is scary. It's thankfully exactly where I was trying to go, but now that I'm being forced to go there, I'm a little bit more perturbed about the idea of going there. The game's just saying, no, you have to go this way now. You can't go to the elevator.
You can't go back the way you came. You have to take this escalator down to this other floor that you've never been to before, and it's the only way you're allowed to continue. That's unnerving. All right.
All right, Sokai, come at me. I'm on my way to Mano.
That's interesting, right? Going from Sokai to somewhere else to then to a place called Mano, who then opens up a backwards air side I haven't been able to go to before. That's neat. And that'll take me back to Kamiakedo, which takes me back to Wanoki, apparently. Oh, you're high level. Oh, that's a bad. Oh, that's a gun. Oh, that's a real bad. Oh, that's a real bad. Fuck you. Fuck you. Fuck you. Fuck you. Okay, we're fine. Oh, that was a real bad. Oh, that was like the exact thing you don't want to happen. Is to have obnoxiously high-level characters show up in these low-level zones and cause me some real problems. Hoo-hoo. Hoo, okay. No, not that one. Let's eat things. That's why I have machetes with me, just in case. Holy crap. These are some slow heals now, too. Alright, then. Alrighty, then. We'll see how it goes. I guess I should try to throw sleepy stuff at them if I get a chance. Anything I can to get an advantage. Hopefully we just won't get swarmed with haters, though. You dick. You dick of a game. A long sword. Oh, it's one-handed. Oh, that's neato. I'll put that on and try it out. And you're cooked. Especially now, if that's gonna happen to me. Yeah! It honestly mostly looks like a silly toy sword, if we're gonna be completely honest. Figures those kinds of things would make their appearances sooner or later. Not everything can be silly household appliances, I suppose. There's some copper down there. Here we go. Ooh. I thought that was an animal over there at first. But nope, even more stuff. Nice. We have a haul now. Also, despite the risk that was apparent, I do still have the life shroom active, so I may get saved by that. I say may because the whole point is that it's supposed to save your life when you're under attack. It's supposed to save you from a killing blow. But, I think I've only been killed once while it's been active so far, and, it didn't save me. Because they immediately did the execution attack. Hi! Oh, I don't like you. I don't like you at all. Oh, I don't like these guys. I don't like them. Oh, they're bad. Aggressive murder. Okay. Stop that. There you go. See, I see where you're coming from, but also stop living, please. There we go. So yeah, it definitely just pays to be as aggressive as you can with those enemies. Just shower them in murder punches as best you can. There's another problem waiting for me down there, though, so look forward to that. But yeah, trying to evade their attacks is like a fool's errand, so instead, it seems best to try to block a few and then just go for it. That guy looks like a problem. I don't quite recognize it for sure. I'm not 100% sure if it's the same enemy we've seen before. If it's the same bulky dude from before or a slightly different one. I am moderately concerned, especially because I am completely naked.